Tracy M.O. Alright, treat all.
I came in his name, I'm saved by his grace. He could show you how to live your life without sin and without lies. The devil took him on a mountaintop and offered him every kingdom. He would not stop and said, Son of man, worship me. Come on over and bend your knee. I said, I came in his name. I'm saved. For 12 good men, disciples is what we go. Then there was Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, and they told the story after he was gone. How he was born and raised. It only took 3 days. In his name we are saved, but only by his grace I
got food, shut up, I'm not going anywhere. Been out twice today, you div. You're not getting your cuddle yet, you can get lost. I'm still playing. This one goes out to all you natural girls. On the day you were born, God looked down at the place you lay. He took a deep breath and he blew on the clouds and blew them away. Heaven and earth he built, took him just 6 days. Took him twice as long to make that smile for your beautiful face. He said, cause she's a natural girl. Sent a letter to Capris, they made a recipe for your eyes, and took the twinkles from the stars, placed them inside both your eyes. For me, for me, for me, for me, cause you're a natural girl. Blushed at your beauty when they come.
your legs, in your arms, your feminine charms, those charms. Cause you're a natural girl. You're an actual girl. Someone sent a message to my father up above. Tell him I found this girl, the one I truly love, the one that he sent down from heaven up above. She fits me just like a glove. Eat your food and air your dip. Stop coming in here with that. Cause you're a natural girl. I'll climb the walls, clamber the highest steeple. At the top of my voice, I'll sing to all the people. I found a girl, I'll love the one. I'll write your name on Venus, Jupiter, Mars. So when you look up at night, see your name is written in the stars. Cause you're a natural girl. Good evening, students. How you all doing? Did we have a nice day on a non-spinning stationary flat Earth? Yeah. The old Johnny Rivers, why not? Let's have a bit of Johnny Rivers. This one goes out to all you GIBs, Girls in Black. That's about it. There it is. There's a man who leads a life of danger. Everyone he meets, he stays a stranger. With every move that he makes, there's another chance he takes. Odds are you won't flip-flop me tomorrow. To all the girls in the KGB, secret agent man. To all the girls in the Secret Service protecting those secret female presidents, secret agent man. Yeah, they've given you a facelift, but take away your soul. Beware of pretty faces that you find. A pretty face can hide an evil mind. Oh, be careful what you say, you'll give yourself away. I'll die, you won't flip-flop me tomorrow. To all the girls in the MI5, secret agent man. To all the girls pretending to be male boxers, secret agent man. Yeah, they're giving you a breast lift and taking away your soul. Double mastectomy. Swinging on the Riviera one day, lying on the Bombay or the next day. Oh, don't let the wrong word slip when kissing those flip-flop lips. I'll tie you or flip-flop me tomorrow. To all the girls that pretended to walk on the moon, secret agent man. To all the girls pretending to be flat earthers, globe earthers and concave earthers, secret agent man. Yeah, they've given you a breast lift, take away your soul. That one goes out to all you secret agents, yeah.
See, when you know he's there, why would you go against his will? Once you know God's real, why? Oh, we haven't played this one forever. Well, my daddy left home when I was 3, and he didn't leave much to borrow me. Just this old guitar and empty bottle of booze. Now, I don't blame him because he wouldn't hit, but the meanest thing that he ever did was before he left, he went and named me Sue. Well, he must have thought that it was quite a joke, and it got a lot of laughs from lots of folks. It seems I had to fight my whole life through, cause some girl would giggle, I'd get red, some guy would laugh and then I'd bust his head. I tell you, life ain't easy for a boy named Sue. Well, I grew up quick, I grew up mean, my fists got hard and my wits got keen, and I've roamed from town to town to hide my shame. But I made me a vow to the moon and stars, I'd search all those honky-tonks and bars and kill that man that gave me that awful name. Well, it was Gatlinburg, mid-July, I just hit town and my throat was dry, and I thought I'd stop to have myself a brew. And at an old saloon on a street of mud, there at a table dealing stood, sat the dingy, hey, mangy dog that named me Sue. Well, I knew that snake was my home sweet dad from a worn-out picture that my mother had. And I knew the scar on his cheek and his evil eye. Well, he was big and bent and he was grey and old. I looked at him and my blood ran cold. And I said, my name is Sue. Let me get in front of the auto cue. How do you do? I hit him hard right between the eyes. He went down, but to my surprise, he came up with a knife, cut off a piece of my ear. But I busted a chair right across his teeth, and we crashed through the wall into the street, and we was kicking, gouging in the mud, the blood and the beer. I tell you, I've fought tough men, but I really can't remember when, cause he kicked like a mule and he bit like a crocodile. And then I heard him laugh and then I heard him cuss, and he went for his gun, but I pulled mine first, and he just stood there looking at me, and I saw him smile. He said, son, this world is mighty rough, and if a man's gonna make it, it's gotta be tough. And I knew I won't be there to help you along, so I gave you that name, said goodbye, and I knew you'd have to get tough or else you'd die. And it's that name that helped make you big and strong. He said, now you just fought one hell of a fight, I know you hate me and you got the right to kill me now, I wouldn't blame you if you do, but you ought to thank me before I die for the gravel in the guts and the spit in your eye, cause I'm the son of a gun that named you Sue. Well, I got all choked up and I threw down my gun. I called him me pa, though he may be me mum. And I came away with a different forensic point of view. And now I think about him in my head now and then. And every time I try and every time I win, if I ever have a child, I'm gonna name him Horatio. I did rewrite this one once on the fly. I rewrote. It was very hard. Did it go? I think something to do with a tucker. Oh yeah, I remember. Well, I got drunk and I met a tucker. I took her home and I had to, because I'd have forgotten what a lady garden looked like. I looked right between her eyes and there was a penis between her thighs, and I'm sure I was drunker than you.
something like that. There's a good tradition of love and hate. Standing by the fireside, there's a good tradition of love and hate. Standing by the fireside, though the rain may fall. Your father's calling you, you still feel safe inside. Though your mom's too proud, your brother's ignoring you. You still feel safe inside. Though was this solo, was this yesterday, was this true for you? All the rest have taken time. It didn't leave a lot for you. Today it's a grim. All the corners laced with memories. Tell me how it used to be. Your mother smiles and children play. And bad things happen miles away. Strong feelings never bother you. Hold your head up while the rest of us try to. Call the stations, call the people. We all want to know. Cause whilst all the rest have taken time, you didn't even wanna know. Well, there's a good tradition of love and hate. Standing by the fireside, there's a good tradition of love and hate. Standing by the fireside, though the rain may fall. Your father's calling you, you still feel safe inside. Though your mom's too proud, your brother's ignoring you, you still feel safe inside. Oh, was this solo? Was this yesterday? Was this true for you? And whilst all the rest have taken time, it didn't leave a lot for you. It didn't leave a lot for you. Go on, let's sing one for God and we'll start the show. This one goes out to you, my Heavenly Father, the Almighty High. Well, I heard there was a secret chord that David played and it pleased the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do you? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor form and the major lift, and the baffled king composing hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Broken, hallelujah.
barely going on below. But now you never show it to me. Do you? Well, I remember when I moved in you. Holy Ghost was moving too. Every breath. Maybe there's a God above, of course there is, but all I've ever learned from love was how to shoot somebody who outdrew you. And it's not a cry you hear at night. It's not somebody who's seen the light. It's cold and bruised. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Oh, I'm sat on my foot. My leg's gone numb.
Okay, boy. Go sleep, is. Yes, little fella. We'll see you in the morning. Yeah, we'll see you in the morning. Right. Let's close the music window. This tiny keyboard's really weird. It's good, but it's weird. It doesn't weigh anything. Go and lay down. No. Lay down, Marlo. Stop. He was sitting nicely. Go and lay down. We are looking at... Oh, you want a cuddle? You want cuddles, don't you, before the stream? Oh, you cheeky corner. Okay. Don't make out you're just going to sit there, because the minute I start to love you, you start fighting and biting. So don't make it out. There you go. I knew you was going to do it. Get off me. You cheeky. Oh, oh, my leg. Right, let me... let's copy the stream out first. One second. Yes, you're beautiful. Your little ginger fair ball. Copy and Facebook paste book, should I say? This is John Cena with sloping shoulders. It is 1 second. Let's post this, 8 p.m. every night. We'll change the picture so it says it on the picture now, hopefully. Voila, it does. Monday Night Live, 8 p.m. every night, post. There we go. That should help the people that don't understand that's my channel. I wonder if it's ghosted when I post it. Only so many of you can see it, I don't know. Twitter, tweet. There we go. And we come back. There we go. Good evening, one and all. Welcome to the show. We are the livest of all transvestigation channels. I've got an empty list, haven't I? Yes. Fair use, excess of copyright material may under certain circumstances be created verbatim for purposes such as criticism, news reporting, teaching,
and reporting research without need for permission from a payment to the copyright holder, to the noddy holder. We are looking at the male and female skull, which should we do? As you can tell, look, the male has got a bigger face. Look, you can tell the male has got a bigger ratio of face. So when drawing a triangle through the eyes, you can see the male's got a bigger triangle. Like this, look. Ta-da! This is what the triangles teach you. They teach you the placement of eyes to teeth. A big ratio is a male face. A smaller ratio is a female face. And this is the same worldwide. There are regional variations. Some women can have wider eyes in certain countries, but they still remain female. The males of that country have even wider eyes. It's just a fact. It's the way it is. God made it so. He created male and female in all types, but one he made in his own image, you and I, male and female, created he them. There we go. That's the skulls. They come in male and female only. It's a 50-50. It's a 50-50. Before we start, why not? Aired it again this morning. Ready for bed. Where are we? Oh, no, not that file. This file. There we go. As if it don't remember. Yeah, it should have done. We had a real good picture. Which one was it? It was this one. Right. So, yet again, a numpty voices its opinion without proof, of course, just or at least without showing people what they're talking about. Let me just move that over there 1 second. You can go there, bum, ba, da, bum. And then we can get rid of them, can't we? Yes, delete. There we go. So, I hear it all the time. You can force fit either skull into a face. Yeah, but does it look right? You see, we don't need those skulls to recognise a male and female face. We can tell the difference already. You understand? Because we've studied the two skulls. They stand out to us. The big square jaw and the far apart eyes with a short forehead versus a flat forehead with rounded coffee bean eyes, sloping jawline, pointed chin. We recognise them without the faces. But you said you can force any face into there. Oh my gosh. I don't know how many times we have to go through this. 1 second. The difference is, because we've learnt the difference in the faces, it took us a while to understand what was going on, but then all of a sudden it was like a jigsaw puzzle. Everything just snapped together. And we'll bring that one in just for good measure. Right, so oh, hello me, that's me. There we go. So what they did was they took a male face, which has wide eyes and a big ratio of triangle, and took the female face and turned the female face into a male face. But it is very recognisable, the differences, the distance in the eyes, and the colour of the lips, the placement of the ears, etc., the sloping jawline, pointed chin. It becomes very identifiable once you understand what those skulls look like. Now, we don't need those skulls because we already got this image rendered in our minds, you see. We just look at people and we see one of these two faces. It's pretty simple. Men have a much squarer head and women have a much more oval shaped face. So when looking at a man and a woman, you will see the squareness of a man's face is below his eyes. Look, that's how square. It's like a bowling ball. It's as wide, almost as wide as it is long, whereas the woman's is longer than it is wider. So when we look at these faces, we can tell the bigger male skull without any of these skulls, just by looking at the width of the cheeks or the length of the face and the closeness of the eyes. This is how we do it. This is how we do it. So when looking at celebrities, it doesn't take us very long to master the art, and it is an art, of forensics when looking at faces. The long, narrow face of a woman, not very wide at all, close set eyes and a big forehead, versus the wide head, the wider cheekbones and a wide jawline with a bigger mouth. All these factors, plus the square jaw and the square shoulders, look, and the flat chest, all these factors register when we look at these people, okay? We don't need the skulls, we just do it by measurement look. There are people out there that'll tell you, we can force any, I can take the male skull and put it into the woman's, and I can take the woman's and put it into the man's. Yeah, but it don't look right, because we can already tell what we're looking at, you. This is the bit that gets me. We can already tell. We already know what we're looking at. So, when looking at squashy faces, the one on the right is Photoshop, but it is a very good definition of what they've done right here. Look, the close set eyes, the small nose, the pink lips, Cupid's bow, the tiny ears, the flat forehead, widest in the hairline, look, no cheekbones. This is what they've done, which is why I want to show you that picture. Let's grab one more picky from near. Where's faces? There it is. Right, so I get it all the time. Can we see a real couple? Well, there were very few real couple pictures. This is an old one. I don't see it very often. The square of the lines, the oval face of a woman, the soft lines, the thicker neck. They're all there for the taking, right? But I like this one, this modern one. It's very definable, right? You can see the small dental arch is the first thing you notice on this. She is very pretty. That is a very pretty natural girl. Very pretty at all. She don't need any makeup, even though she's wearing makeup, she don't need any. She shouldn't be wearing any. She'd be even prettier. But there you go. She's got the soft eyes look, no brow bone, the flatter forehead, the small dental arch, the sloping jawline look, and a tiny neck. Compared to the giant neck of the man on the right, look, look at the difference on the necks. The reason this neck is thicker and longer is because that skull is bigger, and you can clearly see it is, which means this face is bigger, matching the dental arch to the eyes, look, because the eyes are far apart, so are the teeth. If the eyes are close together, so are the teeth. A pointed chin versus square chin, and a sloping male skull versus the flat female forehead. And if you want to go and try and slap that male skull into a woman's face and tell me it matches perfectly when I can already see a woman and you're force fitting a male skull in there. That's all they're doing. They're doing this look. They're forcing the male skull into the female face and vice versa. Ding. There you go. There's only one problem when they do this, right? Because the female has got a smaller triangle. She's got a tiny triangle. You got to make that much bigger, face-wise, to compare. Now, when making the female skull bigger than the male's to fit, blah, 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 like that, to make the female fit, right? Look at the difference in them two skulls now. When you know already that the male, well, they are, that the male skull is bigger, right? You already know that the male skull is bigger than the female skull. So when you make this skull force fit a man, you've just grown yourself a 7 foot tall woman. If this was a woman, she'd be 7 foot tall, because if that was a man, that's that would be a full male human, right? A full grown man, then the full grown woman is twice as big, just to match that triangle up to his. You see, this is what they want to do. Let's get rid of that one. There we go. Right, let's come back to class. Sorry. Now we've played with that a little bit. The vintage one still looks. One second. Let me come back. Let's get rid of that. I keep pressing the wrong button. There it is. There we go. Right, now we're good to go. I'll tell you what we will do. Well, let's just move that window over there. I haven't said hello to you all yet. Hello, good evening. Hope you've had a nice day. Let's move some of these requests from Facebook into there first. Someone said that was photoshopped. Maybe the eye one is, but that's a Russian lady on a train, surely. I don't know what that's doing there. What's that? Sigourney Weaver, did you want that one? Shouldn't be there. Oh, actually, I wanted to redo Sigourney Weaver. That was right. What's that? Gary Waterman. I think I've already looked at Gary Waterman. He's the policeman who blew the whistleblowing policeman. Let's get rid of that. Let's bring that one in. What's that? Oh, there we go. It's a Dutch boy. What's this one? Oh, for the idiot yesterday. Medina. Now it's a place, not a person, unless there is someone like that somewhere. What's that one? And Jason Babelli. Oh, there we go. There's another one. Patricia Pay. Oh. Tyler Henry. Two first names. Adam Curry. Bevan Vandoras, whatever that is. I swear we've done that one. Deidrick Gomez. I've not done that one as well. Oh, I missed the page. There we go. Bracker van Duisburg. Dean Schumers. Pim van Lommel. These are all Dutch. Lily Fachachache. Oh no, that's not coming up. Right, okay. Now we can come back to you guys. Good evening, boys and girls. Welcome to the show. Let me say hello to each and every one of you. Who was first in class? It was Tracy Ample. Hello, Tracy Ample. How are you doing, Treatle? Hello, Denise. How are you doing over there in Australia, babe? I hope it's nice and warm. I know it is because it's Australian summertime. Wintertime coming now, and it's on the change as we're getting summer. Truth Duff, welcome to the show. Went to see Phantom. Is that Phantom? Went to see Phantom of the Opera last night. The show was full of them. Of course it is. Andrew Lloyd Webber. Anything that's Broadway or stage themed, East End, West End, it don't matter. It's them. No natural people allowed to entertain like that ever. Because you can influence people, right? Your words will influence people. Where are we? Anna Souza, bon dia, babe. How are you out there in Portugal? Gregor G, many blessings. Ryan Martin, many blessings. Welcome to the show. Teacher, I think you've got one wrong. Shiloh is male. No diamonds when war. What do you mean I got one wrong? On the stairs, I think we need a second opinion of race. No, I don't think so. I think I was bang on. It's a double flip-flopper. It's an FTM to MTF. You need to go back and study Gates again and again, and then come back and you can give me your second opinion. Right, Screw Froof, welcome to the show. I said hello, Tracy. D Morrow, welcome to the show. Many blessings. Roberta, many blessings. How are you doing, sweetie? Agent D, what's up, mate? And many blessings to you. Rick Stewart. Hello, Rick Stewart. How are you doing, mate? Long time no see. Many blessings. Jeannie Business. Hello, welcome to the show. Liz Perrault. How are you doing, darling? Did I say hello to everyone? I think that's everyone. Oh, Linda Goitel's here as well. Welcome to the show, Linda. Many blessings to you. Right, let's get the show on the road. Give us some requests, boys and girls. Let's have your requests to add to these. And we'll continue where we left off. Well, on the first one, sorry. We didn't leave anything off. We finished the list. Goodbye. What was Roberta's. Roberta's was schoolgirl, wasn't it? Was it school? Schoolgirl H, was it? No. I can't remember. Vitaly. Oh my gosh. Vitaly. Here we go with a big, massive. You're having a laugh again. Zdrovsky. Oh, there we go. Russian YouTuber. Craig Nabon. Craig Nelson. Enrique Iglesias. I've already done Enrique. I'm sure I have. Enrique. I'll have a look. I know I've already done it. It's already been done. Claire Nassia. Where I've lost my way. The Iraq. Another YouTuber. Names are going fast. Wait. Harold Torres. Rory Jennings. Which actor? Rory Jennings. Jose Luis Perales. Dean Cain. Superman. I've already done it. That one's already on the list, I'm sure. Look at her. She went through the menopause bad, didn't she? Old Superwoman. Chris Lilly. Two first names. That one. Australian comedian. I'll take it. That's that one. Froggy Eyes. Jose Luis Rodriguez. I want Carl Cox, can't find any gates. I think I've already done Carl Cox. I don't know if I've got the gate though. I think I've got two gates, as I recall, I'm not sure. Tracy Brabin. The mayor of West Yorkshire. That's a bit close to home. It's like right round the corner. Where are we? Jamie Foreman. We've done that one. EastEnders. Yeah, we've done that one. That one's already on the list. I know it is. Schoolboy Q. That was it. Schoolboy Q. Schoolboy Q. Melissa George. I've not done that one. Melissa George. Maybe not. We'll have a look. Melissa George. Vincente Fernandez. Oh, I like your art, mate. Go with me, poncho, nice. Joel Kinnaman. Swedish actor. Okay. Where am I? Clive Tilsley. Oh my gosh. Clive Tilsley. There we go. Didn't have to do anything. Clive Tilsley. Esther McAvoy. McVeigh. There we go. Catalina Sandino Moreno. Oh my gosh. Catalina. I can't remember what the second one was. Catalina. I've lost it! Where am I? I can't see it now for looking. Catalina Sandino Moreno. Sandino Moreno. What a name. I missed one there. What is it? Did I miss one? No, I didn't. Hayley Davidson, I did miss one. Hayley Davidson. Sounds like Harley Davidson, doesn't it? Hayley Davidson. Is it a golfer? It better be, because that's the only thing that come up. Nassim Haramein, a physicist. Oh, I do like scientists. I do. I love doing them in. Kinsey Wolanski. There it is. Influencer. Kinsey Lewanski. Vicky McClure. Why does that name ring a bell? Vicky McClure. English model. No, don't recognise him now. Next, Vicky McClure. Oh, we've shot too far up now. Now I can't see where we've gone. Where have we gone? There we are. Stay. Yeah, somewhere around there. Tommy Tiernan. I don't know if I've done Tommy. You might have got me there. Stephen Mulhern, we've definitely done that one. I'll look, but I don't think it needs doing again. I'll check it. He looks like Leonardo DiCaprio. Stephen Mulhern. Enrique Iglesias, no meme on Twitter. We'll have a look. Ian Hart, been ghosted again. Ian Hart, footballer. Jake Bug. I swear down we've already done Jake Bug, haven't we? Jake Bug. I think we've already done that one. Name as well. Kobe Cotton. Teddy Tree Fire. Kobe Cotton. Dude Perfect. What's that? Something online. Next, it is Zeraldo. We already looked, there was no pictures on there. Zeraldo, brilliant Brazilian author. Got a swan, there was no gates for this one. Let's continue. Where am I? Gracie Cavallo. Gracie Cavallo. Brazilian model. He's got a big jaw, hasn't he? Next, Alison Jordan. Two first names. Alison Jordan. We zoom browsing. We've already looked. Yeah, there's nothing. It's not happening. We've already looked because it's there already. Next, Howard Wilkinson. Former football manager. Okay. Da 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 da. Da da. Where am I? Karen Jane Woodward. Karen Jane Woodward. Jelena Karalusa. Have I not done that one? It sounds familiar. Jelena Karalusa. I could have sworn we've already done that one. We'll have a look. Jane Leaves. Where am I now? Jameson Newlander. Garrett Hilbert. YouTube. Garrett Hilbert. Well, no. Cody Jones. Nacy McKeon. Nancy. He's got big teeth. Tyler Tony. Oh, that stinks, Marley. And he's down there. It's all the way over there and he stinks. Where are we? Brenda Fricker. doesn't matter. It's an old actress, isn't it? Craig Nelson. Craig Nelson. Craig T. Nelson. We've already done that one, I'm sure. Craig T. Nelson. Andy Burnham. Andy Burnham. I think I've done him as well. Yeah. Mayor of Manchester. Where am I now? Rebecca Adlington. I think I've done that one as well. Rebecca Adlington, the swimmer. Yeah. I think I've done it. He's got some deep set eyes, that one, hasn't he? You know. Where are we? Dr. Umar. He's such a twat. Dr. Umar. American activist. Dr. Umar. Don Yale Lund. Daniela Luna. Mark Martel, Turkey Tree Fighter. Mark Martel. Canadian musician. How many more we got? Right, stop. I don't need any more. I don't need any more. That's fine. No more. Right. Ian Jury. Already done it. Did it just a while back. Freddie Mercury. Oh. That one. Dennis Forrest. Dennis Forrest. Lucy Cave. Oh, we've done that one. Lucy Cave. That's a lot. Lucy Cave. Moving up. Journalist. Lucy Cave. Ferris Antoon. Ferris Antoon. CEO of Mind. Oh, he's got some close together eyes, hasn't he? You can't tell by looking my arse. Right, let's open that one. Chris Norman Singer. There we go. Idler Barber. Idler Barber. Oh my gosh. What is it? Idler. Idler Barber. Oh my gosh. Barber. You better find it because I can't be bothered. There we go. Where am I? Jake Bon Jovi. Have I not done that one? Jake Bon Jovi? I swear we have. Jake Bon Jovi. Jake Bon Jovi. I swear we've already done that one. Jake Bon Jovi. Maggie Gyllenhaal. Well, I've done that one, haven't I? Are you sure? Oh, Maggie Gyllenhaal. I swear down that one's been done. Jim Petrovic. Jim Petrovic. Right. That'll do. I don't need any more. I'll take them two in orange. Alison Lange. Alison Lange. That one. Actress. Michael Bauer. Michael Bauer. And that will do. There we go. Right, I've got plenty. Thank you for your requests. We will start with, I don't know who it is. Right down here, I think it's going to be Dutch, probably. Mark Messerschmitt. His name's Messerschmitt. Like Metatron, Metatron, but with more poo in it. Lay down, you. Right, Mark Metashits. What's a name? Images. Images. There we go. Right, it's an Australian multi-millionaire. Actually, Shiloh, Jolie, well, not Nelson, Shiloh, Jolie, Pitt. You're saying this is a boy, is that what you're telling me? You're telling me this is a boy, you're telling me I've got a girl, sorry, a boy. You're telling me it's a boy, right? It's a girl to boy to girl. It's a double flip-flopper. But you're saying I've got it wrong and it's actually a boy. Let's have a look. No brow bone. Close set eyes. Face squashed downward. Sloping jawline. Manicured chin. Very soft clavicles. Game over. It's a girl. So is that one. And that one behind him. Still a girl. One on the right's a boy, though. The one on the right's definitely a boy. Foot looking outwards at the back. Foot looking kind of inward. Outward, sorry. But yeah. Over and on it, on it. Yes, you can find shots of Angelina crossing his legs over. Sometimes you can find Shiloh with a space between his feet. But the general consensus of all these pictures are that it's a girl, inline footfall. Like that one. That looks male, right? But that one certainly doesn't. Neither does that one. That one definitely isn't. It's even got the hip twist. Shoulder tilt, hip twist. These things are not replicable by a man try mimicking it because his hips don't do it. Yeah, very similar to Brad. But the consensus of all these pictures show an inline footfall. Over and over, and that's why I go for five gates. I always pick the five gates. I'm still seeing a double flip-flop. This one's definitely a boy on the left, but I still see a girl look, flicking her leg inward. Boys can do that as well, I know. Still seeing female over and over. Calf muscle stops about halfway down the leg, look. Should be higher up like a ball, right? Yeah, there you go. They've all got messed up gates, the whole family. Someone made a good point the other day, though. Madonna had six children. How come you only ever see one? What happened to the other ones? That's a really good point. Well, do you think that all of her children would become famous like the Pitts did, or the Obamas, or whoever? You would think this, right? Yep. Have I done Megan Fox cross-dressing children? No, not yet. They're not old enough. I wait till they get old enough, like, Shiloh's old enough now, right? Back when Shiloh was a child, I wouldn't have wanted to do these investigations on them. I wouldn't have wanted to do that. Shiloh, that one, right? I wouldn't have wanted to do these investigations on them when the children. Jesus said, anyone who abuses the children. These children have been abused since they were born, right? So. My main problem is when I meet God is that I cast a stone at a child. And it ain't happening. Jesus warned me about casting stones at people. Let him without sin cast the first stone. I can't do it. If you think you're holy enough to cast the first stone on Brad, because it was done to Brad, Brad just repeated what was done to her, to the children. It's a multi-generational thing. It's a satanic cult with Luciferianism all over it. Some people keep saying that, like John Lennon was trying to break free. These ones that spoke out about the child abuse, Paul Walker, they were speaking out, they were good ones, they were telling the truth. It's all nonsense as far as I'm concerned, because it comes from them. Absolute tosh, every single bit of it. They've lied about everything. They made up fake dinosaurs, for crying out loud. They can make up anything they want and then just print it, have a load of shills, tout it out there to make it believable to you. What did Hitler say? Tell a lie big enough, everyone will believe it. Tell it frequently. And that's the problem with a lot of stuff, a lot of the rabbit holes. It's just a load of people shouting off a lot of stuff frequently. But it's not what I'm seeing. They're like, oh yeah, the chemtrails in the sky. Right, I admit they can manifest clouds and make it rain, etc. Right? I admit that, they can do it. It's been on telly, Jeremy Clarkson showed NASA doing it from a machine, cloud making machine. So yeah, they can make clouds. What they're saying is there's barium, strontium, aluminium, all this stuff, and it gathers on your windshield and you can grab a magnet and all this. It's bollocks! I get up every morning and my windshield is not covered in tiny metal particles that I could drag, not even noticeable to me, let alone grabbing a neodymium magnet to drag them across my windscreen. For videos like that, all you gotta do is go put some filings on your windscreen and film yourself. Oh, look at this guy this morning, look at all my windscreen. And you've made yourself a video and you've made yourself a few million views whilst doing it. It's all easy to fake, right? If it's easy to fake, then that's not proof. It should be available to court reference, right? And be used in a courtroom, as is forensics. Shiloh, I still see a little girl, not a boy. I see a soft-faced girl brought into the world as a boy, changed back into a girl. Someone said she wanted to transition back. They don't get a say in what happens. He was born a girl, brought into the world as a boy, Shiloh, and then when Shiloh came of age, Shiloh turned back into a girl. But all the boys in the world think that when they transition, they're going to look as good as Shiloh does. But they're not, because it's actually a girl, isn't it? So it's all confusion. That's all it is. From start to finish, absolute confusion. That is not a little boy at all. That's a little girl right there. But as is the world, the decision's yours, right, folks? I'm just here as your teacher to teach you the difference in a male and female gate. And that, my friends, is a female gate. Till the cows come, that's a little girl. Till the cows come home, that's a little girl. Right, that is a little girl. Till the cows come home, that's not a little boy ever. That does not look like a little boy to me at all. That one does, though. That one definitely looks like a dude. But we're done. Right, let's go back to my investigation, which was Mark Messerschmitt. Oh, is that how you say his name? I don't know if that's how you say his name, but there you go. Let's have a look at this. It's a multi-billionaire, they said, Australian. It's got a small skull. Straight away, it's not a cannonball, is it? It's not a bowling ball. It doesn't perch on top of a giant neck, you know? These imposters, that's what they are, they're imposters, they're not real men, not real women, rule the world, and they do so under the rule of a fiat currency in every country. It's a federal bank. It's not yours, it's not the people's money, it's a private bank that's taken over the world worldwide, until they owned every bank and made money at an inflation that people can't buy a house anymore, people can't get a car anymore. I was watching a video the other day and a guy was like, I grew up in the 1960s, my house cost me $5,000, my car cost me $500. And I know, inflation, it would have still been quite a lot of money back then, but in comparison to what you've got to pay now, for the money you get and the new build. At least back then they had proper housing, you know, all the old three-story Victorian houses and all them out, they're gorgeous. The new build's not so good, right? Not even close. The builds are not even the same. Not designed to last the test of time, right? Like an old boiler back in the day would last your whole life. Your washing machine would last you your life, or a fridge, it'd last your lifetime. My nana had the same fridge when I was growing up, right through. Never needed to change it. Right, let's have a look at this Mark Metashitz skull. Let's give you a skull check first. Very reminiscent of Ronaldo, tiny face, high set ears, small dentures, tiny dentures, little six teeth on show. The effervescent crow's feet on show, really young. And an Adam's raisin implant look. Yeah, but it's got an Adam's apple. That's not an Adam's apple. That's not a knife. This is a knife. It's one of them moments, isn't it? Reminds me of Denise Richards. Who's that? Victoria Swarovski. Sounds Russian, Polish. How much is he worth? 31 billion euros. This person here. Jim Ratcliffe, worth 20 billion. Both of them are girls, look. Eggheads, widest in the hairline, widest in the hairline. Pink lips, Cupid's bow. I don't want you to picture your boyfriend, I want a picture of you first. Smarmy looking bitch. I think that'll do. It's a nice, where's your jaw at, mate? It's a nice picture, it should do nicely, 50 feet, oh actually. No, that one's too small. We will take this one. Let's go gate shopping with Mark Metashitz. Inline footfall. There we go. That's what we're looking for. Full mint. Game over. It's a girl. You can't be £31 billion richer than the rest of the world unless you're walking in line and you look like a man, but you walk like a woman. Was someone posted who made that meme yesterday? It was Freemasons. Born a boy, raised a girl. That was an ace meme. It made me giggle. I can't remember, it was last night I saw it. It didn't half make me titter. Is that another one there? It is, but I can't see your legs. That's a shame. Look, you've got the hip twist, look. Shoulder tilt as well, look. Shoulder tilt, hip twist. Woman, all day long. A man can mimic a woman's walk, but he can't mimic the shoulders and the hips because they don't have that motion. Don't have that rhythm, that rhythmic motion that a woman has when she walks. Wagunk, wagunk. Wagunk, wagunk. It's the chicken nom noms, that's what does it. Right, so this is a Red Bull millionaire. Oh, he owns Red Bull. This one owns Red Bull. Is that who he is? Is he owning a Red Bull? Well, his boyfriend's got straight legs and he's got a broken leg. What's going on there? What is going on there? Broken leg. Hey, that's right, Tracy Ample. Who needs that much money? It's all nonsense, right? Because if Mark Makershits, whatever his name is, Mark Azapu, if Mark Azapu was a real man and you had 31 billion euros, that's 31 times 1,000 million. In American money, in English money, it's even more, isn't it? In the English way, the decimal way of paying, doing it. You would help people. You've got more money than you could ever spend in your life. You would help people, particularly in your own town, your own country. You would help people. With that kind of money, you could set up your own bank, finance free, just to help people who need money, who can't afford interest on money that's already got interest on it. You're borrowing £1,000 with interest, but it's only worth 700. That's how bad things are, is that fiat currency, people think it's worth something when it's a promise to pay the bearer. Before, the promise would have just been that you do your job. There would have been no money. There would have been no money at all. People would have just done it for the love of doing it. And there would have been none of this hierarchy where I'm a doctor, I get £100,000 a year. You're a sewage cleaner. You work with crap and gunk all day. You go home reeking of that bloke's poo and mine, and you get a fraction of his wages. It seems highly dodgy to me that a doctor who's meant to care for people is bribed by big pharmaceuticals, because it's all money based, right? To use their products or their medicines or whatever it is. It's all a big scam and sham. I wish God would shut it down right now. I really do. If I was God, I'd have shut this crap clown show down a long time ago. But God has a lot of faith in all of us. Or for at least those that he knows are listening and care. God has faith in you. It's not the fact that you've got faith in him. It's the fact that he's got faith in you. He knew that you was going to care. The only reason I can imagine that I got awakened to this truth is that God knew I was going to care when I found out. He knew my mother wouldn't care. He knew my cousins wouldn't care. He knew my best mates wouldn't care. But he knew I would. I didn't realise when examining the truth how people around me were going to react. I had no idea how my family was going to react, my friends, etc. But within just a few weeks of speaking truth, I realised that I didn't have many real friends at all. And even the ones that were left were just faking it. They were just faking it because they loved me a lot, right, as a friend. They just faked it and went along with it. And then somewhere along the lines, like, it took 3 or 4 years for one of my best friends to finally crack. And just flippantly, she said it flippantly. Who cares about all this shit? And in an instant, I knew my best friend, who I loved to bits, didn't care. Couldn't give a crap. Says that she loves God and all the rest of it, but in reality couldn't give a crap. Doesn't care whether this is the truth or not. And that's heartbreaking for me. It is, because I thought I chose my friends wisely. I did. But most of them are heartless and cold. They are. I'm not saying that any of them are worthless. I'm just saying that they're heartless and they're cold. Jesus warned me not to cast my pearls among the swine, or to take friendship in it. Because you can't change them, right? You cannot change. Someone has to want to change. You had to change yourself, right? When you found out the truth about this clown world, whatever the truth was, you changed yourself. And in doing so, people didn't like you anymore. All the people that you really thought loved you don't like you for speaking the truth. For caring more than they do. I do care, and the truth is this. You cannot become a Red Bull racing car driver. You cannot become the owner of Red Bull unless you've got the wrong skeleton. You have to be a girl. And your husband has to look like a woman. And that's the rules of this game. That these giant fake... Look at the teeth on them two. They're both derby winners. You got this egghead in the back, look, with the tiny teeth. And then this huge grill on both of them. It's like looking at a pair of jaguars. But because we were born into this upside down inverted world, it became normal to look at women like this. We thought, for most women, they look at these and they think they're quite pretty. Most men would say, oh, I'd, a few beers, I'd bang that one, I'd, you know, because that's how men are. For me, it bothers me that I'm being deceived. Not just about the shape of the world and about God and everything, but the fact that I'm being deceived about what men and women look like, it really, really bothers me. My child, Horatio, he grew up from the age of 7 knowing the world was flat. At the age of 12, he found out about this. And ever since 12, he's now 18, 6 years on, is more of a man than I ever was at that age. You know, he's still a boy. He still finds farts funny and all that. You know, he's a young lad. But compared to the masses out there, he is more clued in and tuned into the truth than you could ever imagine. Teachers, all of his social workers, their heads were in bits after talking to him. Because he left them with nowhere to go. You know, whatever subject they tried to make a fool out of him on, or to try and ridicule me on, your dad says the world's flat. Yeah, but water's level and you can't show me a picture of bendy water. What? Bendy water, you think water's bendy, right? You live on a ball, water's bendy? Yeah. Well, how can it be level then? How can we put shelves up using a spirit level if water bends? Even the slightest degree, the slightest gradient, water rolls. It doesn't stay level, it rolls downward because it's a liquid. And it's that simple, simple truth that just batters them, doesn't it? Grown adults can't work it out, they're in cognitive dissonance land. La la land. Yeah, but gravity. That's the answer. That's the fallback, gravity. Okay, explain gravity. Did you know the theory of gravity? Because it's not a fact. The theory of gravity was invented by a woman, Isaac Newton. And Isaac Newton wrote a book 3 times thicker than the Bible. It started with the word if. If. It starts with the word if. The whole theory starts with the word if the world is spinning. And isn't finished. 3 times thicker than the Bible, and it's unfinished. It's a theory. That's why it stays in theory land. If you want to believe a bunch of lying inverted masons that you're spinning around at 1.4 million miles an hour in 4 different directions, God gave you free will. It's your choice. Is that him there? Who's that? Dietrich Mateschitz. That must be the mother. She's a mincer as well, look. Yeah. Arms akimbo. Like mother, like daughter. Oh, and there's dad, look. There's mum and dad, look. There's dad with a square shoulder. Look at dad's clavicle. Dad's neck, dad's shoulders, dad's long arm, dad's very straight legs, dad's jack. Hello, wildlife and visitors. We're looking at, what's his name? Mark Mateschitz. And just by pure coincidence, his mother walks, legs akimbo, look. Look at that McDonald's arch in there. It's shaped like an house, look, like the roof of an house. Only women do this. Fails forensics, we're done. Let's go back. I don't need that one. Mummy and daddy, don't need that one. Is he in that one? He is on the right, him there on the right, mincing, right? Yeah, take that one. Mark Mateschitz, save image. Let's go back two horses, Grand National winners, and welcome to Kempton. We will take your flamingo foot, Mark. Same image. I quite like that one, even though his legs are missing. I still like the twist and the tilt. We'll take it. Let's go back. Where's the money shot? That one's all right. Inline footfall, but it's the next one that seals the deal. Hello, sweetness. Well, hello, Dolly. Well, hello, Dolly. We are looking at Mark Metashitz and the owner of Red Bull, apparently. Thanks for playing CSI with us, love. Till next time, take care. God loves you. Where are we? This one, Anthony Hopkins. It does look like Anthony Hopkins, right? The original picture apparently has got his eyes photoshopped in. I still think it's the same person with their eyes open, just not blinking. Where is that picture? I could have sworn it was the original. He's got upside down again. That one, eh? Who's that? Look how close together her eyes are. No brow bone look, flat forehead, widow's peak, dial end for Mongo's. It's an upside down egghead. So is Hopkins. They say you can't tell by looking, but you already know this is not the truth, right? Because you can tell just by looking. I've taught you how to. The skulls work perfectly, right, boys and girls? They work perfectly to train you how to look at these faces. Where's the one with his eyes open? It's not there. Dang it. It does look like Anthony Hopkins though, doesn't it? It's just some Russian lady. Some woman in a train somewhere. And it looked like Anthony Hopkins. They may have superimposed Hopkins' eyes into those slots. I don't know. But the actual face there, that is not Anthony Hopkins. There, that is not a shut up. It's not even close. Let's go back. Anthony Hopkins. Are we done that? Oh, Anthony Hopkins. Let's get rid. Right. There we go. Sigourney Weaver. We're doing a redo on Sigourney. Because I looked at the picture and it's really old. Damn, that looks like a friend of mine. It's so scary. She's a big girl as well. I can't wait to bump into her. We're gonna find out. We're looking at what's his name, Sigourney Weaver. We're looking at Sigourney. That looks like a 50-50. That one definitely is, I think. Save image. The reason I like a 50-50. Give me joy in my heart, I sing. You can go over there a second. Let's open that. Let's drop that. Downloads. Sigourney. The reason I like a 50-50 is this look. Ta-da! That is why I like a 50-50 picture. It gives you the answer straight away. It really does. There's no messing with it. You have to find a picture that is 1-to-1 ratio, 50-50. The gap at the top and this equals 50% of the face, right? Top and bottom. So you got a 1-to-1 ratio of the skulls. Boom. It's a man. No messing. Close that window. And come back. So Sigourney Weaver, we will take that as your face, Sigourney. The life that these people lead may seem very flamboyant and full of wealth and riches, But if they have got a conscience and they have got a soul, would it not weigh on them what they're doing? Maybe that's why some of them turn to, some of them may be actual drunks, maybe it's not made up, maybe some of them are drug addled addicts because of what's been done to them, and they can't stand what they're doing. In God's eyes, that's very forgivable, right? Of course it is. Very, very forgivable. Right, let's have Sigourney Weaver. We've got his face. You don't need me to skull check that, dear. Let's open up Walking. Oh, I did get it. This new keyboard's a little bit weird on my fingers. And we're done. Almost. We are done instantly. I can see five gates. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 already. Let's take them. Two boys walking. There's Sigourney on the left. Can I have that picture, Daily Mail? I can have that picture. Thank you very much, Daily Mail. There's another one. Straight legs again. Same on this one. If you haven't seen Sigourney's Son at the Beach, we'll have a look in a second, if I can remember. If we don't find it, actually, we might find it. Oh, we did. There it is. If the word of today is anything, it's Kelly Clock Springs. If it's not Kelly Clock Springs, it's your back is falling out of its pouch, mate. Look at those. Till the cows come home. That's a bloke. That's a bloke with some right Kelly Clock Springs hanging out his undies. But anyway, we're not looking at Sigourney's Son. We're looking at Sigourney. That's my second. I need three more. I know there was more up there, weren't there? Two, three, no. Oh, that is one. There's my third. I thought there was Harrison Ford on the left, but it's not. It's Kevin Kline. Is it really? Right, three. I need two more. Do, 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 do. One more. Amazonian. That's the word you're looking for. All 6 foot ten of him. Sigourney Weaver is a beast of a man, isn't he? Absolute monster of a man. There's a picture of him stood with Mel Gibson somewhere. And the size difference. Let me find another gate. Is that you? It's not a good one. That one's fine. Right, there's my fifth gate. Sigourney Weaver is a man. Save image. I forgot what I was going to look for. Dang it. Oh, Mel Gibson. Sigourney Weaver with Mel Gibson. Let's see if it's not coming up. Oh, were they in a movie together? Were they really? There we go. Is he doing a George Clooney? She's a big fella, isn't she? She is though, isn't she? The small petite frame of a woman, the soft eyes. Mel Gibson. Heartbreaking, isn't it, ladies? When you fancied... He looks like Rob Lowe there, the soft eyes and the eyelashes. When you fancied a woman for years, this one, and then you finally realise it is a woman. And this must be quite a strange thing, you know, to have the man with the... Well, barely any boobs, but the woman leaning over, looking at his... flat chest and his huge clubs. It's also backwards. It's so, isn't it? The bloke's got boobs and the woman's looking at him, wishing she had them back. I don't know. Sigourney Weaver is a dude. There is no denying it. There is a picture from Sigourney Weaver, Alien. This one. Not that one, though. There's another one. Not that one. There's another one. Where is it? Have you scrubbed that picture? No, there it is. Well, hello, Dolly. If anyone can tell me, can we get a bigger picture of it? Oh, there you go. To all those people at home. Ah, woo! You know what that is, don't you?
Oh, you touch my tra-la-la. My ding ding dong.
My ding ding dong, boys and girls. You touch my tra-la-la. There's Sigourney's Alien. It's in his undies. If you didn't see this picture before, there's an even better one than that, I'm sure. Mine's closer than that as well. It's a real good view of that penis. But there is no denying it, right? That's a cock and balls in there. That is not a hairy bush. Is it? No, that's a penis. He's got a P-E-N-I-S. Till the cows come home, Sigourney Weaver is a man. Okay? It's a man. Thanks for playing. See as I will meet next. Gary Waterman, YouTube. I don't think there's any images of this person. I did have a look. Yep, there's no pictures. I do believe this is... Oh, I don't know. Maybe that's not him. No, that's not him. I don't think it is. Apparently he's a whistleblower, but there's no pictures. I'm sure I did check him. But there's no pictures, so there's nothing I can do. Danish handball player. What's handball? Is it like soft? No, like volleyball. Is that handball? What's handball? Oh, we're done. On the teeth alone, I fail thee. Massive far apart eyes. A short sloping but wide forehead. Wider cheekbones. Wide jawbone. That is quite the neck he's got on him. That's a little bit of ridging in there. A little bit of corrugatedness. Let's have a look at him properly. Flat shoulders. Square shoulders, should I say. Is that the wife there? Oh, we're done. Do you know what that looks like? That looks like the Wachowski sisters. It looks like the fatty one. It really does. Flat-chested, broad-shouldered. Look at those clavicles. Look at the master. Look at the neck on it. Granted, this is a much bigger girl, but then look at the fivehead that accompanies her. Absolutely. You're always going to have a baby. Ah, because I'm gonna have a baby. Holy moly. Look at the size of that fucking hand. Oh my gosh, that's a big hand. It is though, isn't it? That's a big hand. It's a good job his head's in the way. I'm telling you now, look at the size of that. He looks like, what did they call that thing off the Fantabulous Four? The Thing? He looks like the Thing. He's got a hand like the Thing. Oh my gosh, there it is again. Look at this hand. We need a better picture. We're going to find one in a second. Let's have a look. Show me your hands. No good. Uh-oh. There they are. Fuck! Whose hands are those? Oh, you fancy yourself as a bit of a boxer, do you? And Dorothy Tandruff. What are they? They are claws. Hello, wildlife and fisheries. No, you've got the wrong department. I'll put you through to paws and claws. Look at the size of them hands. Hulk smash. And coming up, Ali. Coming up. Ali up. Come on, then. Come on, then, Ginge. Ali up. Yeah, you div. Don't lie up. Don't. Crash on me like that. Here we go. Right. That is some big hands, isn't it? That is some massive hands. Handball play, you say? I'm taking the piss. Holy moly, look at that head. Look at that knuckle. Look at that middle knuckle. Oh, you fancy yourself as a bit of a boxer. Oh, that is a dude and a half, that is. Oh, he's a big fella. He truly is a... He's a righteous dude. Let's see if we can't get his face in 50-50. That's close. Look at his jawline. Oh, my. Lions and tigers and bears. Oh, my. It's a diesel. It's an absolute diesel. That is not an upside-down egghead, is it? It's as wide as almost as it is long. We're looking at... What's his name? Anne. Anne Dorther Tanderup. And that right there is a beast. An absolute beast. Will you stop licking my toes, you weirdo? And there, nice neck. Look at that neck. Look at that trachea. And they over here, look, nothing. It is neck o'clock. Absolutely neck o'clock. Handball. This is the game that they play, is it? Is it like dodgeball? Is that what they're playing? Is it dodgeball? He's got some massive... Look at the size of that shoulder. Are you sure he's not a brickie? He's got brickie's hands. Right, let's... see if we can find him walking. Anne Todoroth. Anne Dorther Tanderup. Anne Dorther Tanderup. Come on. Keep them pictures coming. Ooh, there's one. She's not good though, because he's not in real life. I want to see real life though. That's not good. We ran out of pictures pretty quickly, folks. Hawking. Give me pictures, I dare ya. Is that the wife? That is the wife. Broken leg. Look at that look at the McDonald's arch between the legs. Look at the triangle jaw. Hip twist. Gail all day long. Why is it showing me him and not her? I'm looking for her. No pictures. Oh. Ooh. Hang on. I didn't put a space in there. It don't make a difference. Let's try public. Oh, that's a shame. I really wanted to do this one. Oh. Enter. Search. Come on. Tigers are playing. Can I please have his gate? Goodbye. Nothing. Doesn't want to give me his gate. That's a shame. Ain't that a shame? Try wedding. We're going to try wedding. You're the one to blame. Da-da-da-da. They are getting married. Nothing. There's nothing I can do about it. He's got big hands. He's got an even bigger smile, hasn't he? Wow. Yep, that's a big dude. There's not a lot I can do, sorry. There's no gate pictures. Next. Alejandro Garnacho for the Mongo yesterday. Who did he play for? That's a lot. Alejandro Garnacho Ferreira is a professional footballer who plays in Premier League, Manchester United. We've already done him. Have we already done Garnacho? That's the question. Let's have a look. Oop. Let's have a look at the back file. Let's see if he's already on the list. Paste. Alejandro Garnacho. No. Not on the list. Okie dokie. Let's add him. Pink lips. It reminds me of a young Bez who was talking about yesterday. I'm happy wonders. They all look like Lesos though, don't they? To do. She looks like a lesbian from the end of the bar we used to work in. Right, let's get your face, Ganacho. At some point, you got to ask yourself, what bloke looks like that? And the living is easy. Fish are jumping. Da 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 da. There's no gate showing. We need a 50-50. Get off, Marlo. I'm not messing. Tibby. Don't you sigh at me. You just sighed on me. I still need your face. I'm looking for a gate as well, but that one'll do. There we go. Oh, it's too small. You've got to be kidding me. Good enough. Da-da-da. This one's had a lot of surgery done to her, hasn't she? Still can't get rid of those pink lips, though, bitch. Is that a soft eye? Look at those eyelashes. You make me feel so young. We are looking at, what's his name? Ganacho. Ganacho. Is that a 50-50? That looks 50-50, isn't it? We can go with that. Even with a jaw implant, look, still doesn't look male, does it? It looks wrong. Still rounded, soft features. Let's go walking. That'll do for the face. Ganacho walking. Walking. Division, division. Oh, he's got pink football boots. I got a triangle where there shouldn't be a triangle. I got triangles on a cloudy day. Are you gonna give me some gate shots or what? What's that? Finally, in line shopping with the husband. Female, male. That one looks male as well. Look, knees together, knees apart. There she is. Hello, sweetness. How are you doing? It's a girl. So the cows come home. Gate proves everything, right? Everything I just said, confirmed by the way she walks. Ericsson. Who's that? Manchester United score. That's not him, but it's a mincer. Who's that? Alejandro Ganacho. That is not Alejandro Ganacho, is it? They all say his name, and it's not him. Right, let's go back a pick, and we'll take it from there. Still looking for four more. I got flamingo when I walk, triangle in my knees. Come on. Oh, no, that don't count. You're letting me down. What's that one? Oh, I can't see it. Do 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 That's great. I was going to say that's Mason Greenwood. It doesn't look like Garnacho. Garnacho. Annie, are you okay? Annie, are you okay? Are you okay, Annie? Annie, are you okay? Are you okay, honey? What's that one? Well, the goalkeeper's definitely mincing, look. It's just it is in line, look. In line foot. Lay that heel back, and you've got this footstep, look. Nice, crooked, broken leg, look. See it? I could take that one. It's all right. Ref. What's got your attention, puppy? Something's riled him up. Lovely, isn't he? He's lovely. Hey, Marley. Hey, puppy. Hey, puppy. You beautiful. Just waking up out of nowhere, you did. Get off, you do. Stop it, you do. Kicking me. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. That's Garnacho, isn't it? It is. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. You're getting a little playful, what you little do. Stop it. Start licking all my toes, you do. Stop it! I don't know who that is. But that's a Mega Mince. Oh, so it is. Let's go back a picture, it's no good. I did press backwards, didn't I? That's the first time all night it's done that. You stop licking my toes. Stop it. Stop it. Will you stop it? Daft dog. It's paused up again. That's the first time all night it's done it. That's not bad though, right? Compared to how it used to be. So let me go backwards where you're already. Wait, I don't, why am I waiting? Oh, you stop that, Marley. Div. It's done it again. Is that in there? That is in. Give us that picture. I want that picture. Oh, give me that picture. Right, I'm going to take this picture. That's what I want. Get off my toes. Well, let me have it. X.com. I'm going to go to X and grab it. Save image. Thank you. Right, there's one. You fill up my senses like a barrel of turkey. Get off my feet, dog. Oh, is that a stair fail? I do believe it is. Oh, hello, sweetness. Knees opening when descending stairs. It's only a single stair, and that's all I need. What else we got? Come on. It's jammed up again. That'll be so you do. Come on. It's paused up again. Lagging me out. It's been fine all night, look. And then right at the end of the show, it starts lagging. Why? Ah. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. It's paused up again. It won't let me have a gate. Annoying as hell. How many gates did I get? Four. I think I got four. Mano. Why is that not going backwards for crying out loud? I did press backwards, didn't I? I did. It's taking forever. There we go. That's the money shot. We can take that one as well. The flamingo. Hey flamingo. Hey flamingo. Oh, is that a better one? No, it's the same again. But I've seen his willy. Ganacho fails forensics on playing CSI. Next. Man United player. See you later. Patricia Pay. Pie. I don't know how you say it. Patricia. Angela. Angelia. Margareth Pies. Known as Patricia Pye, is a Dutch singer, radio host, and glamour model. Uh-oh. This one goes out to all you Dutch boys who have been jacking it off to this bloke. It's the Dutch Sam Fox, that's what it is. Teeth like a hawk. Come on. Alley up. They all look like the Bangles. Walk like an Egyptian. Did that? Oh, this was the one that I thought was a Dutch. Who does that look like? Who can remember? Did I say it? I don't know if I said it. Who does that look like to me? A Dutch version of that person. It's the same picture. Have we not looked at this one? Because I've seen this picture and I've looked at that. Alley up! Come on! Marlo, come on! Alley up! Div. Just sat there looking at me. You're not going out. I'm not playing with you. Look at you. I'm not playing with you. Right, Patricia Pye, Pay, Pagy, I don't know, whatever his name is. The mouth alone and the eyes tell you it's a flippy floppy couple. Do, do, do. I recognise that person. I can't think who it is. Somebody Dutch. Is it a footballer or a singer? I don't know. It's a girl. Rounded jawbone, soft features. Look, there's the shadow casting jaw. Look, look at it. A shadow casting jaw versus. Turkey neck. Will you stop licking my feet, you weirdo dog? Right, Patricia Pye gives a 50-50. Too small. Is that him there? Is that him when he was younger? Oh, he was a glamour model. Pearl's a singer. Look at you coming up here to fight with my toes. Get that picture got my attention. Can you say clavicle? Clavicle. Clavicles. It's a man. It reminds me of who was it who sung the EastEnders song? Anyone can fall in love. Anita Dobson. It looks like Anita Dobson off EastEnders. Face is a bit small. I want a 50-50, please. That's too small. Dog's winding me up, chewing on my feet. Yeah, that's me too. You stop biting. Div. Right. You stop putting me off, Marley. Oh, that's an FTM, isn't it? Look at him in the back. Look at that fireman. That's a girl all day long. And dude in front. I don't know who this is. Maybe the son? Daughter? I don't know. That must be the son. Who knows? I'm not yet. Yeah, it is. That must be the son. And Christina. Dude, the dudes look like ladies, don't they? Did I find a 50-50? I still didn't find a 50-50, did I? That's not 50. Is that him? That's not him, is it? Surely. That's someone else. Surely that's someone else. Pie Bird. Oh, it's someone else. It is. Patricia Pye. Not giving me Nish. I couldn't even find 50-50. That's close and it's too small. That's getting better. Right, we're going to take that one as the 50-50. Let's go walking. No, my gosh. Will you please just type in? What this new keyboard's doing my head and walking. There we go. Right, Patricia Pye, we're done. That's a man. I swear down I've done this one already. Two. There's a three. Oh, it's definitely a three. There's a four. And, well, that one I'll do as a five. State of them three. Save image. One. Tell me you're a woman without telling me you're a woman. Look. Knees together, knees apart. I saved that one, didn't I? Let's go back. Let's grab this one. Save image. And back again. Save image. Patricia Pye. Patricia Pay. I don't know how you say it. I don't really care. I've got to be honest with you. Save image. And now we just need your big old mugshot, Patricia. Thanks for playing CSI, was all. Bing. Next. Tyler Henry. Two first names, boys and girls. Two first names. He's off again. Let's check if I haven't done this one already. Tyler Henry. Paste. Tyler Henry, nothing comes up. Okay, let's have a look at Tyler Henry. It's a girl. Reminds me of Antonio. Girls, a pair of them. Do 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 do. Are they sisters? They got to be sisters, right? From his boyfriend's dead relatives. Boyfriend? But you've got awfully pink lips, my friend. Is that my 50-50? It's pretty close. I like that one more. Right, soft eyes, female dentures. Do you know who that looks like? The teeth. Who does the teeth remind me of? Who does that remind me of? Bum 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 bum. I'm seeing Jared Kushner right now, but that's not who I saw. It was the teeth. The teeth and the eyes, that smile, it looked like someone. Not Jared Kushner. Are there any gates? Look, they looked after pictures taken like angels. We're angels. Yeah. Chesney, oh, it does look like Chesney Hawks a bit, now you mention him. Hair. No, it was Brian Cox. The scientist. I'm seeing the teeth and the eyes as Brian Cox. Again, it's because it's a female. They share very close similarities. Tyler Henry doesn't want to give me a gate. He has got a lot of pictures though. Get lost, Marlo. I'm not doing anything. You've got no chance. Nope. Unless you want water. I'll get you some water. Let's see if we can get this one working first. Oh, there's something. Flamingo foot, one. Two flamingo feet. They're still not good. Oh, where's my mints? Someone can explain to me why two blondes are bigger than Tyler.
Well, that'd be nice.
Oh, we're out of pictures. Tyler's got no gates. Oh, there's something. From Flamingo. It's no good. Where's my mints? There's one, but I can't see his legs. Oh, that's just boring me now. There's another one from Flamingo. I just want one full mint. Just the one. Come on in. Alley up. Ah, there we go. Inline footfall and the girlfriend in the back. I do believe we're done. Oh. No, same picture. Same picture. That's not him, is it? Charlie Travers. Never heard of you, Charlie. Let's take that image. One. Two. Three. We'll take that, even though I can't see the legs. From Flamingo. Shared image. And we can take it.
and that one for sure. Nice flamingo, Tyler. Let's take your face and we're out of here. There, that'll do. And shallow. We're done. Tyler Henry, Failed Forensics. Next, Adam Curry, AC, Antichrist Code. Oops, I made the screen too big. My bad. Oh my gosh, there we go. Right, Adam Curry. Podcaster, announcer, internet entrepreneur. I don't fancy your chances. Let's have a look. Is this the same person? Is with Tina. Did that in with Tina? Is that the same person? Adam Curry, Texas Beware of Fakes on X. How I'll always remember hair. Hair, he's got a set of teeth like a, like Seymour out of Little Shop of Horrors. We're looking at Adam Curry, who I think I should know the name of, but I do not know the name and I do not know the face. The square jaw versus the slanted, sloping, rounded chin jaw look. Adam M. Curry, that's not who we're looking for. This one is Adam Curry, too small. We're getting there. That's nearly 50-50. How about that one? We'll take that one. Five head, closer eyes, female dentures, rounded sloping jawline, fake Adam's apple. And I know somewhere under there, there's a fake Adam's apple. Yeah, fake Adam's implant. Raisin. Raisin was the word I was looking for. Adam's raisin implant. She was quite a tall girl. That's a better picture, actually, even though it's not 50-50. That one is. There we go. We'll take that one. Soft, closer eyes, pink lips, rounded jawline, flat forehead, no cheekbones, high set ears. Let's see if we can get Adam, what's his name? Adam Curry walking. Little shop of heart. Is that Adam Curry? Is that who that is? Adam Curry. It was Jeff Goldblum. I was seeing Jeff Goldblum. That's another Adam Curry with closer eyes. Let's have a look at the gate, if it's here. I don't even know who this person is. He's been on Joe Rogan, has he really? Adam Curry, Cabbage Paps. That's a weed plant. Mind you, he is Dutch. Did you say he was Dutch? I don't know. Little Shop of Horrors, got no gates for Adam. Adam's got no gates. Yeah, nothing. We've got loads of pictures though. Nothing of Adam. Nothing to do with Adam, look. Lots of different Adam Currys. Walking. Oh, we're done. There's no pick. Oh, there's one. Is that him? I don't know if that's him or not. It's in life. Oh, I don't know if they're standing now. Actually, they might be standing. Little Shop of Horrors. That is Adam Curry there. So is that one. But none of them are any good to me. Look how slight that is. Knees together versus knees apart. Look. Let's go back a picture. Is that you there? It is. Again, knees together versus knees apart. Gotcha. Please let that be him. That's not him, is it? I don't think that's him. Gutting. There's a load of mincy shots now, but it's not him. Ah, balls. Right, let's come back. We're out of picture. No, it's not happening. Adam Curry's got no gates. Leaving. Next. Bo van Everen Dorens. Dutch TV again. What time is it? Oh, it's 10 past 10. I'll tell you what, boys and girls, I'm going to call that a night. We'll be back tomorrow, Tuesday Night Live. Be there or be square. Just remember, God loves you. He really does. And he wants you to know that you were born in an inside out, upside down, back to front, tipsy, topsy, turvy. Mm-hmm. Well, thank you very much for watching, students. Good night and goodbye. Bye. Lynn! Squeeze it in. Ta-ta.